That is actually freaking incredible, and I want Zoe to take it to a beach and like put it in the ground and fool an archaeologist. Just like go trolling, like find some sort of archaeological dig site.
Yeah.
I'll
I like
go.
to think that, I don't know where she lives. We'll assume she lives in Los Angeles, and there's just archaeologists who are just out there on Venice Beach. Just they get their little picket fences
Trying to
set up.
find dinosaur fossils on Venice Beach.
That's what I like to imagine. But I will say this is directly to her. If you want to mail that to me, just call me or something.
Just call me and I'll be like, why are you calling me? Mail it already.
Because I need something to sit here next to me. The Dark Templar joke, it only lasted so long. Now I'm
No.
back to being envious again.
There's new viewers coming in all the time who can
And I
be
can just
like,
repeat that joke.
yeah, I have this wonderful Tychus Findlay marine figurine
Wow,
on my
Sean,
right.
that's a really great figurine. It doesn't match up with my Dark Templar statue
For those
here.
of you who have been with us since the morning, please let us know how that joke was the second time around. This is the Team Liquid Day 9 TV Community Heart of the Swarm launch party, where we, as commentators, joining forces to celebrate how awesome everyone is in the whole wide world, gotten the chance to look at some of the teams, the players, the.
White Raw with guns.
Yeah, I was trying to think of a way to say like White Raw, like the man
I like
himself.
to think that you gave White Raw very specific directions. Be like, okay, you make a Protoss tutorial video, talk about Protoss or the Mothership Core, and he just sends you like, well, here's a bunch of weapons. And you're like, we're gonna roll it.
Dude, I will say, the big thing that everyone who is always, getting into the community, wanting that first big step, I always hear stories about people at their first major tournament. Maybe there's a bar craft going on, and one of their friends said, "Hey, you should come and watch this event," and they were just sucked in right at the start. And I think the most notable Far Northern tournament, DreamHack, I have been three times. Jönköping and Stockholm are beautiful, and the DreamHack crew is amazing.
Yeah, the watching that event, I am always blown away. They are one of the best ran events, and if you do not watch them, you're missing out because I think it's a great showcase of StarCraft as a whole.
Absolutely. And in fact, DreamHack has this amazing history where in Jönköping they get a huge crew of really passionate volunteers to help set up the whole event over a week. They have tens of thousands of not that's so tens of thousands. I hope I'm not. They have hundreds of millions of computers. I'm worried I'm going to get the number wrong, so that's
Several
fine.
billion
Several
computers.
billion attend the LAN. Well, DreamHack has a history as being the world's largest LAN party, and it's incredible to see them set up over the course of the day. And of course, as esports has grown larger and larger and larger, DreamHack's been amazing having events in all over Europe, really. The Valencia event, I think, is one of the most recent ones outside of Sweden that people have really caught on to. So, coming up next, we have a wonderful video, a time lapse to see what it takes to set up a DreamHack event.